previously we discussed about two type of the cataract, congenital cataract and acquired cataract. So today we discuss congenital cataracts. Full term we known as congenital and developmental cataract. So the congenital means which the patient received by birth, and developmental means in the sequence of development of lens. If cataract is developed, that is known as developmental cataract. So firstly, we discuss about etiology. Some factors here disturbing the etiology of normal lens. First etiological factor is heredity. It is a chromosomal anomaly, usually dominant mode. Some factor like maternal factor and fetal factor are also working. Maternal factor like malnutrition, protein energy anemia, protein energy malnutrition, iron deficiency anemia, etc. Then infection like rubella, even rubella syndrome also, where the eye, heart and ear combinedly affected. Then drugs like corticosteroids, thalidomides, etc. Then radiations. Then some fetal and infantile factors are also work. Then anoxia means lacking of oxygen due to placental hemorrhage. Some metabolic causes, Laus syndrome, birth trauma, especially in forceps delivery when pressure appear here. Then malnutrition. Malnutrition is responsible for both type of feature, congenital or by developmental, by after birth in the infancy group. If the child is malnourished, then chances is high to develop cataract. Then some factors are idiopathic also. These are the clinical types of congenital factors. We discuss one by one. First one is congenital capsular cataract. It's divided into two parts, anterior and posterior. Anterior capsular cataract is non-axial, stationary and visually insignificant, मतलब visual loss is minimum. Then posterior capsular cataract are rare and can be associated with persistent hyaloid artery remains. Then next one is polar cataract. Firstly we discuss about causes of polar cataract and secondly we discuss about types. As the name suggests, polar cataract affects the both pole. So it's again divided into anterior polar cataract and posterior polar cataract. Anterior polar cataract is due to delayed development of anterior chamber or due to the corneal perforation. In the case of delayed development of anterior chamber, cataract is usually bilateral, stationary and visually insignificant. Means it's also a very small cataract, doesn't affect much vision. Due to the corneal perforation, such cataract may also acquired in infantile age group and follow contact of the lens capsule with the back of cornea. If cornea and perforated, then also anterior polar cataract develop. Major causes ophthalmia neonatorum. Then posterior polar cataract. It is very common lens anomaly and consists of the small circular circumscribed opacities. Causes are persistent hyaloid artery remnants, posterior lenticornis, persistent hyperplastic primary vitreous. Then we divide into types. Polar cataract divided into anterior and posterior. Anterior cataract again divided into three types. First one is second white capsule in the center. Second one is anterior pyramidal. Here a pyramid shape opacity develop. The apex of this pyramid towards cornea. Then reduplicate cataract. Reduplicate cataract means a pyramidal shape opacity in the center where apex towards cornea. Then a clear capsule present and the subcapsular area is again cataractous. Okay. So it's also known as imprint or double cataract, where simply use understand as anterior pyramidal plus subcapsular cataract is reduplicate cataract. Then posterior cataract is stationary or progressive both. Then nuclear cataract. Nuclear cataract divided into two parts, cataracta centralis pluvirulenta and total nuclear cataract. Cataracta centralis pluvirulenta is embryonic cataract. So it develops from embryonic nucleus. So the opacity is very small, as much as embryonic lens is only involved. The opacity is powdery in appearance, so we known as pluvirulent. Usually does not affect the vision because a very little part of embryonic nucleus is affected. Then total nuclear cataract. Total nuclear cataract means all the type of nuclear lens, embryonic, fetal plus infantile are involved. So opacity is very large, so it is seriously impairing the vision. It is usually bilateral and non-progressive. Then laminar or zonular cataract. Laminar cataract is a developmental cataract. Means in the developmental phase, means after birth, when the lens is developed, it occurs. It is most common type of congenital cataract presenting with visual impairment. Etiology differ in both type, genetic or environmental. Genetic factor is dominant variety, and environmental factors most commonly caused by vitamin D deficiency. Sometimes maternal rubella infection contacted between 7th and 8th week of gestation may cause the laminar cataract. Then here we show the diagram of laminar cataract. Here the embryonic nucleus is clear and the surrounding part, laminar part which is surrounding the embryonic nucleus, is cataractous, and again the cortical part of lens and nucleus part after the laminar nucleus is clear. So a ring present here. It is usually bilateral and frequently causes severe visual defects. Then sutural cataract. Sutural cataracts are comparatively common. At most common opacity around anterior and posterior Y sutures of the lens. Such cataracts usually static, bilateral and do not causes much vision loss. The individual opacity vary in size and shape and having the different pattern, and thus their name according as under. Like floriform, like petals of a flower, coralliform, in the form of coral, spear-shaped cataract, the lenticular opacities are here in the form of scattered heaps of shining crystalline needles. Then anterior axial embryonic cataract, it occurs as the fine dot on anterior Y sutures. Then if we discuss last cataract, generalized cataract divided into four parts. First one is coronary cataract. Coronary cataract is again a developmental cataract and most commonly occur in the age of puberty. Thus it involves the adolescent nucleus. So the here in the image, the embryonic nucleus, fetal nucleus and infantile nucleus is clear, but the opacities are here in the adolescent nucleus. These opacities lies in a radial pattern, so it's also not causes much vision loss because such part is clear. Because large part of nucleus is clear, only adolescent part is opaque. Okay. Then blue dot cataract. Blue dot cataract is also appear in the adolescent nucleus. Its blue dot cataracts appear here above the periphery of adolescent nucleus. It is small, fine, punctated, dotted like opacity. Punctated opacity are in the form of blue dots. Okay, sometimes some parts of cortex is also involved. These type of blue dot opacities are usually stationary and very small, so it is also not called as much vision loss. Then total congenital cataract. Total congenital cataract affects unilateral or bilateral both. It's a most common hereditary factor, generally associated with maternal rubella, and it is a progressive type of cataract where lastly the lens became degenerated and became soft and liquefied. Then total membranous cataract. Membranous cataracts, they are the total or partial absorption of congenital cataract. Means a cataract formed, then it absorb or degenerate. Only a membrane behind here. So it's known as membranous cataract. So sometimes it's maybe misdiagnosed also. Then if you discuss about management, small stationary lens opacities means like simple embryonic cataract or blue dot cataract, this type of opacities should be ignored. If the opacities are in incomplete central stationary cataract, then optical iridectomy is done, use of miodiuretics to improve vision. And if complete unilateral or bilateral cataract, removal of the cataract as early as possible. We discuss about surgical management. Then anterior capsulectomy means removal of anterior capsule. Then lensectomy means removal of lens and aspiration of lens is done. Correction of pediatric aphakia if more than 5 years, corrected by implantation of posterior chamber intraocular lens. And if the child is less than 5 years, then spectacles should be worn. And after later on, when the child grows and up to the 5 years old, then corrected surgery is done. Then correction of amblyopia is also done. So here we discuss about congenital cataract in the later on class.